Hello, I'm Chris Hernandez, host of The Weekly Report, your news about programs and services provided by the departments of the City of Kansas City, Missouri. Be sure to look for a special message on the streets of Kansas City. City crews inscribed unique and temporary thank you pavement markings on some streets that were recently resurfaced. Mayor Sly James announced the show of appreciation for Kansas City's support of street resurfacing. Last year, city residents voted to dedicate more funding towards street repaving. So far this year, about 180 lane miles have been resurfaced, with a total of 220 miles planned by year's end.
Well, first of all, I want to thank everybody for being here today to say thank you to the residents of Kansas City. We had heard from our residents time and time again through our citizen satisfaction survey that the condition of our streets and roads was of prime concern to them. We asked the residents to help us address that issue, and they said yes overwhelmingly. In fact, residents in every single part of the city voted overwhelmingly in favor of our investing in our infrastructure. And with our resurfacing efforts, we're going to reach every part of the city, north, south, east, and west, because infrastructure is a citywide issue and has to be addressed on a citywide basis. All of that is possible because the residents of this city approved question one. So as a way of saying thank you to all of those residents and to highlight the work of the staff whose job it is to accomplish this goal, we want to make sure that they see a unique message saying thank you applied to the surfaces of the resurfaced roads. And that's what you're looking at. When people see this, then they'll know that we're very much aware of the fact that they're the ones who are responsible for allowing us to do this and for providing us with the resources necessary to accomplish one of the things that always shows up in the top five of their citizen satisfaction survey, and that is take better care of our roads and streets.
To learn more about the city's street resurfacing efforts, please visit kcmo.org/resurface. The city's corporate safety team recently hosted Will You Buckle Up For Me? That's a contest to promote seatbelt use among city employees and their families. Throughout the summer, young relatives of city employees submitted artwork depicting what seatbelt safety means to them. Winners were recognized during a ceremony August 9th.
The kids that are here that participated, we've got kids that won third and fourth and second and first place and all that kind of stuff, but we think all these kids are winners for the work that they did and also for the fact that they are already understand that how important it is to wear a seatbelt.
So we have a couple of points we'd like to bring up. Buckle up. Every time you get in a vehicle is the easiest way to do it. Do it the first thing. It spares you and your family the physical, emotional, and financial burden of an accident. And allows all of us to lead by example so that the children in our lives will know the value of wearing a seatbelt.
The city's Civil Rights Division celebrates the one-year anniversary of its radio show, Discrimination, Report It, Don't Ignore It. This show airs every Saturday morning at 11 on AM 1590. The focus is on civil rights issues and enforcement. Podcasts of the program are available on the Human Relations webpage at kcmo.org. Now let's check in with some of our city's departments.
Hi, I'm Heidi Downer with Kansas City Parks and Recreation. The summer is winding down, but there are still plenty of fun activities happening all over town. Explore a world of cultures at the Ethnic Enrichment Festival, the weekend of August 16th through 18th in Swope Park. This event is one of the largest ethnic festivals in the country, with more than 60 different cultures selling native foods and crafts and entertaining the crowds with music and dance. Admission is $3 for adults, while children 12 and under get in free. Enjoy an end of the summer swim for only $3 a day, now through Labor Day, at the Bay Water Park on Longview Road and the Springs Aquatic Center on North Congress Avenue. Just download a Splash special coupon at kcparks.org. The following weekend, the pools go to the dogs. Dippin' Dog swim parties will be held from noon to 2 p.m. Saturday, September 7th at the Bay Water Park, and from 1 to 4 p.m. Sunday, September 8th at the Springs Aquatic Center. Admission fees are $10 per dog and go to help local rescue organizations. For more information about these and other events, see the Parks and Recreation website at kcparks.org or give us a call at 816-513-7500.
CPD and several other local, state, and federal agencies coordinated a warrant sweep this past week targeting the most violent and prolific offenders. For the first time, the work of NOVA, the No Violence Alliance, was integrated into the initiative. We spoke with Captain Joe McHale, project manager for KC NOVA.
The NOVA and the Narcotics and Vice Division have looked at a list of individuals that's based on data. We've got a list of 2,161 individuals that are all connected to aggravated assaults and homicides for the past 2 years. Of those 2,161 people, over 700 are currently wanted. That makes our job real easy to go out and begin to impact this group through arrest and prosecution. The tough part that we need to follow up with in this operation, though, are those that are on the periphery, those that are on the fringe that may not have reached a felony level yet. For us to use the client advocates at NOVA and the different medicines available to take the cycle of violent crime and the people that are headed down the wrong path and give them another option and a different way to go. This is a very violent group of individuals. The average aggravated assault nationally is 241 per 100,000. The aggravated assault rate in this group of individuals is over 3,000 per 100,000. This is just staggering. There's already 21 dead in this network of individuals, which makes a person that's in this network of 2,161 people 100 times more likely than me or you to be killed. There's a certain core group of individuals in this network that the only option for us is jail. They need to be removed, and if we don't remove them, the rest of the people in their network can't heal because of the influence and the positional structure that person holds over those individuals that are on the periphery. Individuals that haven't necessarily risen to the felony level yet, that may be on the periphery, have a low-lying warrant, maybe traffic warrants or some type of an issue that's not related to violence, maybe we can take them and put them on a process to where we can help them with social service, counseling, job training, GED assistance. Whatever need that person has, our advocates can help them get on the path to that structure. Here's the NOVA message. The NOVA message is, we know who you are. We know who the very small percentage of people are in this community that are causing the problems. We know who their friends are. They can either accept our offer of help, or they can take the arrest and prosecution. We want them to change their lives. We'll help them change their lives. If they choose not to and continue to go down a violent path, we will arrest them and prosecute them to the fullest extent of the law.
Keep in mind, the goal of the sweep is more than putting people behind bars. For those individuals just beginning to commit crimes or hanging out with those who do, our community is offering resources and opportunities to live a useful and productive life. I'm Officer Shelley Gaddis. Have a safe week.
Looking ahead, residents are invited to the city's quarterly Neighborhood Leaders Roundtable meeting. It's at the Kansas City Library Plaza Branch on Thursday, August 29th from 6 to 7:30 p.m. This meeting will provide residents with information on neighborhood services and offer residents and community leaders an opportunity to talk with city staff members. For more information, please call Tiffany Drummer at 816-513-3210. Have a public improvement idea? Come to one of our four upcoming citywide meetings for the Public Improvements Advisory Committee, also known as PIAC. Meetings take place Friday, August 16th from 9 a.m. to noon at City Hall's 10th floor committee room. On Tuesday, August 20th from 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. at the Gem Theater. On Wednesday, August 21st from 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. at Hillcrest Community Center. And on Thursday, August 22nd from 6:30 to 8:30 at Northland Cathedral. For more information about this or any of today's stories, please log on to kcmo.org, scroll down to the bottom right-hand corner, and click on the Weekly Report. That does it for this edition of the Weekly Report. I'm Chris Hernandez. Have a great week.